Evening. Tonight we'll find out which two teams will contest next month's Capital One Cup final at Wembley. It's certainly been a competition to remember, and we'll reflect on another magical 24 hours, well, for the neutral anyway. Coming up this evening's dramatic and somewhat bizarre events at the Liberty Stadium as Chelsea try to overturn a first-leg deficit against Swansea. We'll also look back on last night's match as five-time winners Aston Villa aim to come back against Bradford of League Two. Mark Bright's here to share his insight into another amazing round of matches. And here's a quick reminder of what happened in those first legs. Swansea pulled off one of the many shocks of the competition when they beat Chelsea at Stamford Bridge 2 weeks ago. Goals from Michu and Danny Graham giving the Swans a two-goal advantage. Tonight, we find out whether Michael Laudrup's side could hold their nerve at the Liberty to reach their first ever major Wembley final. And after their incredible 3-1 win against Aston Villa in the first leg at Valley Parade, Bradford were on the threshold of pulling off an historic cup upset at Villa Park. We have all the action from a night of drama in the West Midlands. Well, the Swansea manager Michael Laudrup masterminded a perfect smash and grab in their first leg tie against Chelsea at Stamford Bridge. So the question tonight was, would his side sit back and defend the Swans' two-goal advantage at the Liberty or push on for that all-important third? Your commentator is Steve Wilson.
101 years old, they say this could be their biggest ever game. Swansea City are 90 minutes from Wembley and all they have to do is not lose by two. But this is Chelsea, who've won their last six away, averaging more than three goals in each game. It's already been a good day for Swansea with the news that Michu has agreed a new four-year contract at the club, and they start with the 11 who began the first leg at Stamford Bridge. Chelsea make one change to the side which beat Arsenal at the weekend. Demba Ba is preferred to Fernando Torres up front. Terry is still bench-bound, along with Torres and David Luiz. First time into Mata, scrapping for it with Leon Britton. Mata won it. And that's a decent ball. Demba Ba here for Chelsea. Ba goes over. Chris Foyd doesn't want to know. Ba thought that Ben Davies tripped him. He's having words, the referee, with Demba Ba. Let's look at the challenge from Davies here. Oh, he stuck his foot out and had a little flick at Demba Ba. Well, Chelsea have got a corner. Whipped in towards the near post and headed clear by Michu. Here's Britton. And they can break here. Rangel, options ahead of him, Routledge and Michu. De Guzman to his right-hand side. Here is De Guzman, three in the middle. It's over Michu, driven by Routledge, deflection. And it might have gone anywhere. It's gone for a corner. And Azpilicueta here with a crucial block for Chelsea. That's well hit by Routledge, who knows where it was heading before Azpilicueta made the block. Here's Routledge, nicely done. Michu in behind, good save by Cech. Pablo Hernandez onto the rebound. Blue shirts outnumbering the white in the middle. That could be a really big save from Petr Cech. Pablo Hernandez again. Nice little 1-2. Ramirez there to clear, only as far as Ki Sung-yung. Rangel back into Ki Sung-yung. Pablo Hernandez, Ki Sung-yung again offside. They got him behind so easily here, Swansea. And Michu, so often the man for Swansea City this season, denied by a crucial save from Petr Cech. Rangel long towards Michu. Cahill jumping with a great header. De Guzman arriving. Super block by Cahill. Swansea are asking the question what Cahill blocked it with. certainly did the job. It was a lovely header from Michu to set up De Guzman. Here's Leon Britton. De Guzman. Pablo Hernandez. Ki Sung-yong. Shot hit Cole. And Pablo Hernandez was offside when it came to it. Well, this was dangerous. Lovely header from Michu. De Guzman arriving. Kale made the block. Eden Hazard on the turn, deflection, just had Tramell scurrying for a moment. It's a corner kick to Chelsea, second of the game, 20th minute of the game. 0-0 on the night, 2-0 to Swansea on aggregate. Mata driven in. Came off the head of Williams. Cahill, I think it's gone out for a throw-in rather than a corner, which is what Cahill was hoping for. The throw is being indicated by referee Chris Voigt. Cole, still Ashley Cole. Williams with the block, Tramell making sure it's not going to drop in. Chelsea are just cranking up the pressure here. Quickly taken, Eden Hazard and Lampard involved, then Cole suddenly skipping away through. Michu's chest off to De Guzman. And some aspects of the first, it's offside against Michu. Some aspects of the first quarter of this game will please Rafael Benitez and Chelsea. It's quite an open game. And Swansea are looking to score, which will give Chelsea opportunities at the other end. Ashley Cole, Ramirez, Ki Sung-yong comes out to meet him, well hit and well watched too by the goalkeeper. Little skimming zipper from Ramirez, awkward for the keeper this on what will be a wet surface. Heavy snowfall for good 3 or 4 hours before kickoff. Hazard trying a little trick. He gets a free kick. His teammates would not have thanked him had he not got that free kick after that little flamboyant swivel. Played half an hour now. Chelsea have not made any impact on the scoreboard. 2 hours of football in this semi-final, still Chelsea nil. Swansea have two, Chico Flores with the header away. Mata, deflection, Hazard, chance here, Oscar trying to pick his way through and Williams is there. Well, did he overcomplicate it, Oscar? Well, when it came down here, the shot deflected off bar. There's Oscar, just didn't get the shot away. To be fair to him, the shooting chance was never really there. And Ashley Williams' recovery was in the nick of time. Ramirez, Lampard. Juan Mata here for Chelsea. What a great time to score this would be for them. Eden Hazard, Ashley Cole. Nervous moments for Swansea. Cole's dink ball into the box. Davis didn't get onto it. Demba Ba over the bar. Goal kick. Haven't been many really true sights of the Swansea goal for Chelsea. This was half a chance. Would have been a tremendous finish if he could have put it in, but it was half a chance for a man who's hit the net 16 times this season. Michu might get De Guzman away here. He's definitely onside. Azpilicueta charging back. De Guzman looking for a little bit of help. Routledge is offering it, and he's found Routledge. He can find Key. Michu on the edge of the area. Here's Pablo Hernandez. Has he spotted the run of Rangel? He has. Rangel couldn't beat Oscar. A promising Swansea attack is snuffed out. Lampard. Hazard down again. Chelsea will play on here. Juan Mata. Demba Ba. Bars Carling short is not far wide. Well, Eden Hazard was knocked over by Ashley Williams again. Chelsea played on and nearly to very good effect. I think if Demba Ba had touched it there, he might have been offside, but he wasn't when it was played back into him. And he couldn't find the target. Leon Britton falling over. Davis and Williams trying to make the angle harder. Tremel hurling himself. Chelsea change. Ivanovic is coming off. David Luiz is coming on. Distribution from the back. Ivanovic has been off the mark tonight. Luiz, who of course has played in the centre midfield on occasion for Chelsea under Rafael Benitez, is playing at the back alongside Cahill. It's a change. I'm not sure how it's going to bring them a goal, which is what they really need. Lampard into Eden Hazard here. Hazard keeps the ball in play. And it's a corner to Chelsea. Little will-o'-the-wisp. Eden Hazard flits in and out of games. He's been out of this one more than he's been in it, but his run there wins Chelsea a corner. Juan Mata. Demba Ba beaten to it by Michu at the near post. It's a Swansea free kick. Fernando Torres warming up. Rafael Benitez has been saying this week it would be difficult to play Torres with Ba. But if they're looking to salvage something, it's something he would consider. Well, he must be considering it now. Chelsea need a goal. Ramirez. Oscar. David Luiz. Juan Mata. Bounce back off Bar to Mata. Mata shot, good save by Tremel. Excellent stop, and he held it so well too. Mata turns and shakes his head. Really well hit by Mata. That's one of Chelsea's best opportunities and efforts of this game. Stopped and held. Asked Michael Laudrup the other week after their draw at Goodison Park. Did you ever play at the old Wembley? Won the European Cup there with Barcelona, was his answer. Of course you did. Azpilicueta getting forward from right back. Here's Oscar finding Ramirez. Now Azpilicueta. What an awful pass by Azpilicueta. Eden Hazard goes to try and retrieve the ball. Oh, and the ball boy will not give him the ball. I mean, that really is not on. But the Swansea players here. Oh my goodness me, well the ball boy would not give Hazard the ball, and he's saying, I think, that Eden Hazard kicked him to try and get the ball back. Well, what does Chris Foy do here? Well, the referee's assistant on the far side would have had the best view of this, Simon Bennett. Seemed clear to me that first the ball boy would not allow Hazard to get the ball. Here he is. Hazard wants to go and get it, and the ball boy will not let him have it. And then Eden Hazard tries to kick it out from underneath him. Chris Foy wants to speak to the Chelsea captain, Frank Lampard. Fernando Torres is still waiting to come on, by the way. Chris Foy is going to send him off. Eden Hazard is sent off for kicking a ball boy. Have you ever seen anything like that before? Of all the things you never thought you'd see, that is right up there. and that may overshadow the outcome of this semi-final. Oscar is being replaced by Fernando Torres. Luiz to De Guzman. Dyer. Jonathan De Guzman. Ki Sung-yung in all kinds of room now for Swansea. Good first touch. Ki Sung-yung can't beat Ramirez. Could have finished it himself, could have squared it to Pablo Hernandez. Ran into Ramirez. There may still be a flickering ember of hope for Chelsea. Ben Davies forward to Pablo Hernandez. Swansea can keep the ball for fun. Leon Britton. Death by a thousand cuts for Chelsea. Ben Davies forward. Ki Sung-yung again. 4-2 here, Swansea. It's Nathan Dyer. Dyer shot. Check with a save. Check makes the save. Davies with the interception. Here's Leon Britton. And Swansea come forward again, still with energy in their legs. Against dispirited, defeated, deflated Chelsea. Here's Michu. Michu to Pablo Hernandez. Check. There again. Great tackle by Michu. Ki Sung-yung has lost it to Bertrand. Here's Barr. Six added minutes were shown. Six added minutes have been played. And Swansea City have done it. From 1912 to 2013, the Welsh Cup and the Football League Trophy is as exciting as it has ever been for Swansea City. They've never had a night like this. But then they've never had a team like this. Michael Laudrup, Swansea City, go to Wembley for the 2013 Capital One Cup final. 0-0 on the night at the Liberty. The celebrations begin on aggregate. Swansea City 2, Chelsea 0.
Michael, congratulations.
Thank you.
A performance of great discipline from your side, I thought, today.
Yeah, I think first of all, to be in the final is fantastic. Second, to have beaten over two games the European champions, Chelsea, not conceding not even one goal, I think that's absolutely brilliant.
So we had chances, we made two mistakes, and we were under pressure today. The half chances that we had to be a little bit better at the end. We didn't do it. Credit to them, because they were managing the game well. And at the end, you know, they are in the final, and then all the best for them.
Sometimes you say and you do maybe things that are a little overreacted, but again, there are things that you can not do, never, even if you have 300 pulse. And as I said before, I think Hazard, Zai, retained a very good player. I think he will get it.
He was kicking the ball and getting the ball, but again, we can analyze for half an hour, and still we know that both they were wrong, and that's it.
Well, it's such a shame, really, that most of the talk afterwards is about the ball boy incident. But we have to say, first and foremost, Mark, very well done to Swansea, through to their first ever major domestic final tonight.
Yeah, in their centenary year as well. Many congratulations. It is a fantastic achievement. The European champions over two legs, taking a two-goal lead back to the Liberty Stadium. And thoroughly deserved, I think we have to say. Excellent.
Tonight, after what happened off the pitch, shall we say, the ball boy concerned went to apologise, interestingly enough, to Eden Hazard. Hazard also apologised to the boy concerned.
Yeah.
As you said, when we saw it, it kind of highlights the fact that two wrongs don't make a right.
Absolutely. And this is the incident. The ball goes out to play here. The ball, as you can see, moves towards the ball. Obviously, it's out of shot now, but Eden Hazard tried to get the ball off the ball boy. The ball boy is now holding his side, and this is why. Eden Hazard tries to get the ball boy rolls over onto the ball. Eden Hazard sillily tries to kick the ball from underneath him, and you can see Ashley Williams steams in there. Chris Foy's left with no other alternative but to give him a red card for violent conduct. Now, here we go. The ball boy won't give him the ball back. He tries to kick the ball from under him, and he won't allow it to go. There's the ball boy being taken off. He obviously goes and waits till after the game and goes into the change room and apologises to Eden Hazard. Now, as I said before, two wrongs don't make a right. Mm. Eden Hazard should not have tried to kick the ball from under the ball boy. But that, likewise, if the ball boy's holding on to the ball, what does he do? He wants the ball back quickly. They're losing. Mm. They're going out of the cup.
And an indication, maybe, from the ball boy's Twitter account that it might have been premeditated if it was him who wrote what he wrote.
Well, it looks like his account. We've all had a look at it and we've been following what he said. And he said, the king of ball boys is back for this game. Maybe time for time wasting. Now,
which is disappointing to hear.
Well, it is disappointing now because that's exactly what he did. So it would look like it was premeditated.
Yeah.
And, his followers seem to have gone up, that's for sure.
Yeah. As for the game itself, and we mustn't forget that there was a contest.
Yes.
A bit of a non-event at the end of the day. One of the main talking points came as early as the 7th minute. Should Chelsea have had a penalty?
No, not in my opinion. Demba Ba was the player concerned here, and the defender was Ben Davies. Now, he cuts that ball back. Ben Davies pulls his leg out, pulls it back quickly. Mm. Watch the right leg of Ben Davies. Pulls it back. The right leg of Demba Ba makes contact with his knee. That is not a trip for me. That is not a penalty. I think he's out there looking for it. I think Chris Foy wasn't fooled. Didn't give them the penalty.
Should Barr have then therefore been yellow carded for a dive?
Well, Bell can just say there was contact, wasn't there? It wasn't a complete dive. There was contact. He felt contact. But it wasn't, for me, a penalty. It wasn't a challenge that warranted a penalty.
Surprisingly mute performance from Chelsea, who lacked real energy, considering the onus was on them going into it with a two-goal deficit. But like we said, congratulations to Swansea. Mm-hmm. And a great fairy tale for two individuals, Hugh Jenkins, the chairman, and Leon Britton.
Yeah, I mean, 10 years ago, the club nearly got relegated and
out of the Football League.
Out of the Football League. I mean, and then from there, they slowly worked their way back to the Premier League. And the football they play, the style of football, the brand of football, I think is better this season than last. I think Michu's been fantastic, De Guzman's been fantastic. And the way that they've passed the ball and kept the ball, Chelsea home and away over two legs. You've got to say, you fancy the European champions there. But no, it's been a fantastic story. And Leon Britton as well, he was in the team that nearly got relegated 10 years ago and he's stayed in the team and stuck with him, and been very loyal. We talk about players' loyalty these days, been very loyal and rewarded with a trip to Wembley, and a winnable game, you have to say.
OK, well, as for last night, League Two Bradford were hoping to seal their place in Cup folklore by holding on to their two-goal lead against Premier League side Aston Villa. For Paul Lambert's young strugglers, however, they needed to score at least twice and keep a clean sheet to book their place at Wembley. Jonathan Pearce was at a packed Villa Park.
Fantasy football for League Two Bradford City and their 6,500 fans here. Dreamland is just around the corner. Wembley Stadium lies 90 minutes away. But dreams can tatter into nightmares. Tranmere came here in 1994, 3-1 up against Villa at this stage and lost on penalties. In 15 semi-finals on their own ground, Villa have lost just one to Chelsea in this cup way back in 1965. But for Bradford City, what a night ahead, as they strive to become the first team from the fourth tier to make the final since Rochdale in 1962. Villa make two changes from the first leg. Ron Vlaar has since returned to fitness to captain the side after 7 weeks out. And Stephen Ireland starts for the first time in 2013 with Andy Byman only on the bench after an illness forced him out of the weekend draw at West Brom. Darren Bent is among the subs as well, after injuring his knee at Ballyparade. Bradford are unchanged from the first leg when 35-year-old keeper Matt Duke was the hero. Target man Jim Hansen plays despite a cracked toe. 19-year-old Australian Curtis Good, on loan from Newcastle, again plays left back with James Meredith out with glandular fever. New signing Michael Nelson is among their subs. Bill Parkinson has tried to approach these games as normal matches. It's almost impossible, though, for his players to forget that Wembley Stadium is so very close. Delph, is it written in the stars for him to play a major role tonight against his hometown club? Back towards young Lowton. And Zogbia, one of the few Villa players to draw distinction from the first game. Looking in the box for Benteke. Had he taken an early-headed opportunity in the first leg, things might have been so different. In all, he had six chances in the opening encounter between the two sides.
And then it'll be brought out by young Curtis Good from Melbourne, Australia. A little bit hasty with the pass. Lowton for Villa, looking for Benteke. Good is in front of him, good defensive shape. But it's a header by Benteke and just knocked over the bar by Lowton, who continued his run in there. In the first game, Villa got in a lot of crosses. Benteke was so strong in the air, dominant, but they didn't take their chances, and they've had two already tonight. Joe Bennett with the challenge. And this is where Bradford City will fancy themselves. They'll send their two centre-halves forward. Silly challenge. A bit naive out there, he was going nowhere. They are dangerous at set pieces, Bradford City. 10 minutes played in the second leg. Bradford leading 3-1 from the first. If they score here, Aston Villa will have it all to do. They're looking once again for Hansen. And on this occasion, Big Jim, as they call him, headed well wide. It was a long, long time since Villa had been beaten by a fourth-tier side. January 1964 against Aldershot. Paul Lambert at Wickham through to the semi-finals of this competition in 2007. That's a good cross, Benteke was on the end of it. He's got to start taking these chances. Good ball in, and from that position, really he should do better than that. Atkinson and towards Wells, just rushed that one. Delph, good powerful run, sensibly done, and gets the shot away. It's a good run, had space in front of him, travelled into that space, gets across the Bradford player. Had there been a slightest touch there from Nathan Doyle, he would have gone down. Knows he needs an early goal. 19 minutes gone at Villa Park. The crowd applauds and stands to support Stan. And we continue to wish Stylian Petrov well as he fights back from serious illness. It's always a touching moment here. Kieran Clark looks for Benteke with a set-up there for Gabby Agbonlahor. On to Nzogbia. Agbonlahor can slip up in turns. Duke got down well. Surely not again, Villa feel. Can he do as well as he did in the first leg? The veteran Bradford City goalkeeper. Bradford fans are singing about going up to win the cup. FA Cup winners in 1911. Bennett with the cross, looking for Benteke! 1-0 to Aston Villa on the night! They're right back in the tie! 23 minutes gone! Very good finish from a man who has missed too many chances in this tie so far. Got away from McArdle and finished so sweetly. No wonder the manager is so delighted. Then it moves forward. Strong run by him. He's poked it through to Ireland. He's offside. It won't count. Gary Bezic with the flag. I don't think there was any doubt about it. There's a yard offside. Bradford are defending deep. In towards Ireland. Zogbia. Oh, good save again. He's having the time of his life in this tie. Well, that cleanly away. Good goalkeeping once again. Alan Pardew watching on. Aston Villa's next Premier League game is against Newcastle United. They have to go to Millwall first in the FA Cup. Here's Agbonlahor. Stephen Ireland, little chip. And it's another fingertip save by the goalkeeper. On the night, it's Aston Villa 1, Matt Duke 0. But over the tie, Matt Duke has been a winner. Up goes Benteke. He has won so much in the air. Zogbia. Good strength there. Ireland arriving on the right-hand side. Couldn't get the shot away. Goes for a cross. Benteke arriving. Oh, it's an inch wide. Surged onto it. He's so powerful when he comes from a position that's 10, 15 yards out. Makes that sort of run. Well, now here's danger for Villa. Hines cutting inside. Wells went to bend it. That's a good effort from a very promising player. A reminder there for Aston Villa that they are still behind in this tie and they cannot take chances. Villa fans trying to stoke up the atmosphere. Many of them thought they'd win on the night. They haven't been beaten here by Bradford City since 1935, but could they do enough to win the tie? It's a corner kick to Bradford City. This is where this tie could spin again. McArdle trying to get to the near post. Goes in there now. And Benteke did so well. And so they set themselves again for Jones' corner. McArdle goes near post. Hansen coming in! The dream is very much alive! Big Jim Hansen scores for Bradford City. Villa undone again in the air at a set piece. Aston Villa 1, Bradford City 1. Bradford City lead the tie 4-2. This is the very stuff of football fairy tales. He used to stack shelves to make a living. He just slipped too easily away from Ron Vlaar, and Phil Parkinson was heading it in himself. Here's Benteke to Fabian Delph. Benteke's gone looking for the return. Here's Bannon. Finally wide to Bennett. Sliced across in dangerously and away by McHugh. Applause for the young defender from his teammates. Alert at the far post. And Zogbia with the corner. Clark at the near post. Benteke again. Well, he claims a corner. It's a strong claim too. McArdle has walked away rather sheepishly because he knows it came off him. Derby and Doyle. What a lovely cross. Hansen, oh, he could have won the tie there and then. Could it yet turn on that miss? Big Jim Hansen could have sent them walking down Wembley Way. I think it's just a deflection, a shave of Kieran Clark's head. Bradford dropping back in two serried ranks. Good shape about them. Good defensive discipline. Atkinson coming in to make it virtually a back five there. Now goes wide to Mira Zogbia. Doubling up with Good. That's his primary job. Has been over the two legs and he's done it so well. Zogbia couldn't get free. Agbon Lahore. Lotan. Into Bent. Ireland! Whatever happens between now and the final whistle, when the history of this tie is told, it will be a tale of missed Aston Villa chances. Doyle and Derby and three to the left, and Villa are badly stretched. They're on the edge! Oh, it's off the bar! Great effort. He's only been on the pitch for a few moments, Thompson. I think it was his first touch. Villa then, literally on the edge of a precipice. So unlucky there. The hero of the night against Arsenal. So nearly a hero once again. Weimann has got away from Good. In comes a cross, it's missed by the wall in there. Ireland's first to it. Sadly for Villa, Darren Bennett made a great run, but wasn't fouled. In it comes from Clark. It looked a tired cross, that. Calm, calm, he said. Just a deflection, took it out of the reach of Benteke. And now Turgut. Trying to hold off Stephen Ireland and hold it in the corner. It's wound down a few seconds more. Villa look for the header, Ben. Byman could get in behind here. Andy Byman, Villa have hope. Aston Villa 2, Bradford City 1 on the night. Goodness me, they can't get out of jail here now, can they? Long ball. On by Bent. Oh, a slip. And in with Byman. One more takes it to extra time. It was a cool finish. And Villa simply need to get it forward and quickly. Shea Given will bring it out. 10 seconds of the 90 minutes to go. Given hoists high. Benteke will attack it with Nakagawa. Benteke did his job. Atkinson will welly it away. Only as far as Blah. 4 minutes of stoppage time. In by Lowton. McArdle jumps. It drops towards Turgot. It's a corner. There were one or two tentative appeals for handball against the Bradford City substitute. Surely they can't have this fairy tale, this dream ripped away from them within 90 seconds. In comes the corner. Benteke attacks. It's wide. Bent was in there and hangs his head. I think it was young Lowton who got the header on it. Just a glance. Mike Dean checks his watch. Paul Lambert wants more time. Villa simply have to get it forward. Delph launches it. Benteke underneath it. Derby will get it away. They're nearly there. Bradford City can smell the hot dogs of Wembley Way! What a sensation! What a story! The greatest night in the history of Bradford City, some will call it. It certainly is in the modern era. Aston Villa of the Premier League have won on the night by 2-1. But it's Bradford City who go to Wembley Stadium. 4-3 on aggregate. It is surely the greatest fairy tale in this competition. And Bradford City are there. They are in the final of the Capital One Cup. On the night, Aston Villa 2, Bradford City 1 on aggregate. Aston Villa 3, Bradford City 4.
It's a night to savour, you know, we've made history tonight and, you know, we're really going to enjoy it. The lads deserve it. I thought the second half they were tremendous. First half we gave the ball away and we came under a lot of pressure, but the second half was a different game and I thought the lads played really well and thoroughly deserved to go through.
The lads started really well and they got after it and got the crowd right on it. We looked a threat, we looked dominant in the game and you thought we were going to go and win the game. And like these corner kicks, you cannot defend that way and expect to get anything.
The lads dug in first half, you know, expecting the worst, you know, when they scored early on and, you know, chance after chance, but, you know, Dukie and the back four was magnificent all night, and second half, I think we've done really well, we passed the ball well, and I knew we'd always fancy yourself to score here, so it was nice to, you know, get on the end of a set piece.
You say good luck to them and congratulating them for going through. It's a great achievement. They took ourselves and Arsenal and Wigan in the Premiership, so... Yeah, good luck to him in the final. In the final, anything can happen in the final.
Yeah, nice to hear that from Paul Lambert. Very well done on what was a sensational night for Bradford City. We shouldn't really be surprised after what they've done in this competition, but just to think they are one win away from qualifying for Europe.
It is amazing. I mean, it's one of the biggest upsets in football. You know, League Two, I mean, beating three Premier League teams and one over two legs to get to the final. So Phil Parkinson and the team, the fans, everyone did themselves proud, and, you know, just the prestige of playing at Wembley, and, you know, I've been there in a final. It's going to be fantastic for them. And you know what? You've got to say their name might be on the cup.
Yeah.
Because just the way they've gone about it, because they thoroughly deserve to beat Aston Villa over two legs.
Yeah, well, this is it, because Bradford did ride their luck, I suppose, a little, because Villa more than had their own chances.
Yeah, well, Paul Lambert would probably look at the game and say, 37 chances, 20 on target over the two legs. I mean, they started off really well, packed house, crowd got behind the team, good positive start, and, you know, they bombarded Bradford's goal. But, you know, Bradford were used to this kind of aerial sort of bombardment week in and week out, and Benteke, they used full advantage of his aerial ability, and Zogbi with a great shot. Matt Duku, I think, has been absolutely fantastic for them over this cup run, and that was That was on target, it was a little tip over. So Villa pressed and pressed and pressed, but I have to say, they just missed golden opportunities time and time again. Of course they're going to put Bradford under pressure. They've got to, they're at home, they're on the front foot. But they withheld, in the first half, they withheld all the barrage. The second half, Bradford played a lot better.
Yeah, well, Phil Parkinson clearly had a plan and it worked. I mean, and that was to expose Villa's weakness at the back.
Set pieces. I think set pieces they've shown with Arsenal and with Villa especially. Time and time again, they were a threat. The delivery was fantastic. Look at that, Jim Hansen. I'm just so pleased for him. You know, he hasn't played for 2 weeks since the last game. He's been injured. Vlaar, who's been brought in for his experience, a Dutch international defender, he loses him easily with a bit of movement back and forward, and he crashes that one in. And I just thought, he caused problems all day. I mean, that one there, I think Kieran Clark just gets a touch in front of him, and it just skims off the top of his head. But he was a threat. He led the line well.
And it's refreshing also to hear a professional, you know, like James Hansen afterwards, just to merely say how privileged he is to be playing the game. You don't often hear that these days, do you?
3 years ago, he was stacking shelves, I think, for Co-op. And, you know, in non-league, got himself back into the league. And lots of clubs are looking in non-league for players now who've been in the system, dropped out. Mm. They mature in non-league and they bring them back in. And he's going to play at Wembley in the final. I mean, I'm really pleased for him.
Well, who would have believed it? It's Bradford against Swansea to contest the League Cup final on Sunday, the 24th of February. What an occasion for both fans.
Absolutely. I think Bradford at the start of the season was something like 10,000 to one. You know, to win the cup. I know they haven't won it, but now if you're a fan, you know, everybody has a pound. Oh, I'll put a pound, you never know. Yeah. But great story for Bradford, because 2.5-3 million, who knows how much they've made from this run. Mm. You know, it's going to obviously secure them, you know, £7,500 the team cost. So well done to them.
Certainly. Well, talking of Wembley, you can watch the best of the action from the Capital One Cup final on Sunday, the 24th of February, and that'll be on BBC One. In the meantime, there's live tennis on the Beeb with the semi-final of the Australian Open between Andy Murray and Roger Federer at 8:15 on Friday morning, with the women's final on Saturday at 8:25, and a day later with the men's singles final a little earlier at 8:15, all of them on BBC Two. Mark, thanks for your company tonight. Well, would you believe it? Two clubs who quite easily could have tumbled out of the Football League without trace in the last decade will contest this year's League Cup final. For Swansea and Bradford on February the 24th, just one last push needed to seal their place in club folklore. Good night. Everybody.